What's happening? What's happening? What's happening? Shout out to all those beginner investors and traders out there. Y'all already know who it is, but if you don't, this is Kavai Ray Valentine. You done pulled up to the block market. This is Hood Money Investing. I wanted to show y'all this article real quick. If you are an AMC holder, because Mr. Adam Aron happened to mention shareholders and us being the reason why AMC is going where it needs to go in the future. So I wanted to take this time to read this article so y'all don't have no fear if you are a future shareholder of AMC. I'm not telling you to not think about the squeeze. I'm not telling you to prepare for it. I'm not telling you to get information so you understand, what's going on with the squeeze. I know you want to know and learn as much as possible about how a squeeze happens, when it may take place, you know, the technicals, the data. I get it. But you got to remember what I've been telling y'all, man. The data and the technicals can be manipulated as well as the news and everything else. You just have to go with common sense, psychology, and the emotions, you know, of people dealing with these stocks, man, and these exchanges when you're talking about crypto, okay? So I'm going to take this time to read this little article for y'all real quick so y'all can ease that tension, you know. AMC CEO details early returns from theater reopens and the stock is gaining. AMC CEO Adam Aron says that the opening of Mortal Kombat and Demon Slayer produced our biggest attendant weekend in AMC since March of 2020, and shares increased in an after hours following eight session losing streak. AMC Entertainment Holdings has reopened 589 of its 593 U.S. theaters as of the end of April, according to the company, including this location near Times Square in New York. Man, we're about to get it popping, man. The summertime is not going to be able to hold us back. People been sitting up in the house, you know what I'm saying, looking all stupid, buying just going Amazon crazy. You know what I'm saying? That's why Jeff Bezos and them just had a blazing earnings, because people been getting these stimulus, sitting home, just buying stuff that they know good goddamn well they ain't gonna use. But I'm gonna go back into it. AMC Entertainment Holdings Inc. lost more than $500 million in the first 3 months of the year while reopening almost all of its U.S. theaters, but executive sees brighter days ahead. AMC report first quarter losses of $567 million or $1.42 a share Thursday afternoon, an improvement from a loss of more than $2 billion in the same quarter a year ago, which was mostly due to non-cash impairment charges from the movie theater chain revaluing its properties of the COVID-19 pandemic forced closure across the globe. Sales in the quarter total $148 million, down from $941 million in the first quarter of 2020. The performance was expected. AMC revealed preliminary first quarter results last week while ditching a plan to ask investors to approve the potential sale of 500 million additional shares. And we glad, I'm glad they didn't do that. They would have diluted the share price, you know, and it would have took us longer to reach our potential goal. You know what I'm saying? FactSet reported that analysts were expecting losses of $1.34 a share on sales of 148 million, though some of those estimates may not have been updated after last week's disclosure. Shares gained 2.6% in after hours trading after declining for 8 consecutive trading sessions. For AMC investors, the path ahead was more important than the first quarter numbers Thursday, and Chief Executive Adam Aron laid out some successful AMC. Of the success of AMC has seen so far from the reopening and the company conference call, after recounting being left for dead, AMC was within months of weeks of running out of cash 5 different times, Aron admitted, between April of 2020 and January of 2021. A lot of smart people on this call and many of you were certain that AMC would collapse. Nah, I wasn't thinking nothing like that. Aron then detailed that the opening of Mortal Kombat and Demon Slayer 2 weeks ago created our biggest attended weekend at AMC since March of 2020, 13 months ago, and said that AMC's market share has increased in the early days of theater reopenings as many competitors folded up shop. We have every confidence in looking ahead, then AMC will win. We certainly are well on our way, he said. AMC disclosed Thursday that 589 of its 593 U.S. theaters and 110 of the 357 international theaters it leases or runs in partnership with other has had reopened in some capacity by the end of April. Investors and analysts want to know when those theaters will be filled enough to boost AMC's revenue back to something close to pre-pandemic results. We believe the company has sufficient liquidity to allow it to survive with low utilization through at least quarter three, now that most of the high-earning theaters have reopened. Wid Bush analyst wrote in preview of Thursday earnings report, we think demand for theatrical content is high and plenty of high-quality content is awaiting audiences. And that's how I feel, man. All these movies that we got coming out, Marvel Phases and DC, and you know what I mean? It's just so much going on right now with gaming and how gaming is being transferred and these games and books and, you know, are being turned into movies, and we getting this digital upgrade, this quantum upgrade, and we are starting to live in the digital space. And people don't think that movies are going to be just as important as games is moving forward when we looking at maybe like, you know, another 300 billion, maybe 300 billion or 400 billion coming into gaming. And I mean, it's just so much going on right now. I cannot believe that people would think that AMC would go down when it's a part of entertainment. I just don't get it. That's one of America's pastimes, one of the world's pastimes. I just can't see it, man. I just can't get it. You know what I'm saying? But why executive did not provide specific forecast for the current quarter of the full year in Thursday's announcements, Aron did address in remaining liquidity concerns over the past 13 months. AMC has raised approximately $29 billion of gross cash proceeds from new debt in liquidity capital, secure around $1 billion of concessions from lenders and landlords, obtain more than $150 million of assistance from European governments, and generated more than $80 million from asset sales. He noted in the company's announcements, taken together, we have made well more than $4 billion of progress for our implementing a myriad of capital actions to help us make it through this global storm. AMC stock has been a favor of the Reddit meme stock crowd, which has helped share gain more than 130% in the past year, more than quadruple so far in 2021. Aron noted that announcement that AMC has vocal, enthusiastic, and avid new shareholders base comprised mostly of some 3 million individual stockholders talking about the ape gang, you know, us out here. The stock price has suffered a reversal recently, however, falling more than 21% during eight session losing streak that continued Thursday when share fell 1.9% to $9 a share. So, you know, right there should give y'all a little bit of breathing room so y'all can, you know, breathe easy about AMC and its future, man, because it looks to be bright if you ask me. We just have to sit and wait and be patient. That's all you have to do. You know what I'm saying? Don't get ahead of yourself, you know? And I'll see y'all at the top, man. I just wanted to share that, you know, with y'all so y'all can ease that tension. Y'all already know we're going to Haagen-Dazs, scoop, flip, chip, Tostito, dip, and get this money, man. You know? It's Kavari Valentine. It's the Black Market Hood Money Investing, man. I appreciate y'all for tuning in. I'm out of here.
They out there panicking right now. I can feel it. They out there. They're panicking. Look at them.
Now, you're not naive enough to think we're living in a democracy, are you, buddy? It's the free market. And you're part of it.
Something just came across my desk, John. It is perhaps the best thing I've seen in the last 6 months. If you have 60 seconds, I'd like to share the idea with you. You got a minute?
After everything we've done for you.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put y'all in the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it. I won.
I lost. $1.
Thank you, Louis.
After you.
Certainly.